In this video, we are going to learn how to implement Google Mobile Ads, or you can say AdMob Ads, into your Flutter application in an easy and proper way so that you won't face any difficulty displaying them or face any account banning issue. So if you are new to the channel, please subscribe and press that bell icon so you will be notified whenever a new video is uploaded. So let's begin. So here we have a project named Flutter Ads, and in this project, in the lib folder, we have these two files. In the main.dart file, we have this code where we are using a main method and an app with a home property of home screen widget, and here this is a stateful widget. In this stateful widget, we are returning a scaffold with an app bar and an empty floating action button just for UI and a body. To display Google Mobile Ads into our Flutter application, first we have to import a package. So for that, press Ctrl+Shift+P on Visual Studio Code, and after that you have to type add dependency, and after that you have to type the name of package you want to import. So for now we are importing Google Mobile Ads, and after typing this, press enter. It will download the package and import it into your pubspec.yaml file like this. After that you can close it, and now you have to go to your main.dart file where you want to display your ads. So we have to create some objects and variables for that. First of all, we will create a banner ad, as in this video we are discussing only about the banner ad. In our upcoming videos we will discuss how to implement interstitial, native and all those. So for that, banner ad, and after that name it banner ad. And now we have to initialize it, but we won't initialize it yet. So we'll add late before that. And now we have to create a boolean to use as a flag to display our ad. So is ad loaded, and it will be false by default. And after that we have to create a method to initiate our banner ad. For that, init banner ad, and here we have to initialize our banner ad and initialize it as banner ad. And now we have to provide all these four things. So what are these? We have to provide the size of our banner ad. So the size is easy, add size dot. Now you can choose any of these. I will go with the banner. And after that we have to pass the ad unit id here. So that is empty for now, we'll add it later. Now we have to pass the listeners. What listeners do? They listen to your ad app cycle. So we have to pass banner ad listener, and after that we have to pass request. The request will send a request to the Google server to get an ad. So that will be ad request. So after that we have to use some methods in our ad listeners. What we want to do with the ad? So we can perform all these operations on our ad. If our ad is clicked and we want to increment or decrement something like that, so we can perform it here like this. You can use this ad however you want, but I will use these two methods. One for when ad is loaded, so that we can change our is ad loaded to true and display our ad. For that we'll use set state, because it is a stateful widget, and change this is add loaded to true. Now it is showing error because of this constant, so we have to remove it. And now we will use another method, that will be our ad fails to load. What happens here that whenever a request is sent to the server and server don't give you any ad, in that position we have to dispose our ad so we can get another ad. For that, just simply add.dispose, and after that you can print whatever the error came, and that's all. If you want to customize your request, you can also perform all these operations on your add request. For example, you can pass your keywords or extras, content URL, etc. But I won't do that. So after all this, you have to load your banner ad. So banner ad dot load, and it will send a request to the server, and after getting the ad, it will listen to the ad, and if it is loaded, then our is loaded ad will be true, and if it fails to load, then our ad will be disposed. So it will free our resource and won't cause any lagging or other issues. Now comes the important part, that you have to display your ad somewhere on your screen where it won't interrupt or hide the content of your screen. So if you are displaying all your content in your body section but not using the bottom navigation bar, then you can display your ad here. This way the ad will be displayed at the bottom of the screen, so user won't accidentally touch it or cause any false activity or false click. So your account won't be banned for that. So we are displaying everything in the body section, so we will be using our bottom navigation bar for displaying our ad. Here we'll use our is ad loaded property, and if our ad is loaded, then only we want to show the ad, otherwise we won't show our ad. So for that we'll use our size box, and if is loaded is false, means our ad is not loaded, we'll use our size box again, and this time it will be empty. But if our ad is loaded, we have to pass some sizes to it. So for height, we'll be using our banner ad size that we just assigned here. So it is easy, just pass banner ad dot size dot height dot to double, and same goes for width. So banner dot size dot width dot to double, and after that we have to use the child property, and to display our ad we have to use add widget, and in this ad we have to pass our banner ad. So this is all we have to do here. If ad is loaded, this size box will be executed, else this size box will be executed. So now we have to initiate this method at the beginning of our application, means whenever this home screen is executed. For that we will be using an init state, and in this init state we will call this init banner add method. So everything is done except this add unit id, so let's go and create this. But before that we have to go to the Android folder app, and now in the build.gradle file, and scroll down a bit, and here in the compiled SDK version you have to change it to the latest. So this at this time 33 is the latest, so I have entered 33, and after that you have to pass the minimum SDK version, which is 21, and target SDK version as 33. After that you can close it and okay. Another thing you have to do is go to the source main, and in the Android manifest file go to the bottom of your screen, and here after your first metadata tag you have to enter this metadata tag. I will show you how to get this, so don't worry. So the website is apps.admob.com, and here you will have to sign up, and after sign up this will be your dashboard, and here you have to go to apps and add your application as this is your first time. So here you have to select which platform you are creating this ad for. So I am creating this for Android for now. And now we have to tell if our application is available on Play Store or not. If it is available, we have to pass the URL for that, otherwise we can simply select no. After that continue. And now we have to pass the name of our application, so that is Flutter Ad Testing. And now add app, it will create our application, and after that we can create our ad units. So done. Now we can create our ad units. So we have to select this banner ad, as in this video we are discussing how to implement these, but in our next videos we will discuss how to implement all others. So for now select banner, and here we have to type the name of our banner ad. So banner Android, as this is for Android, and you can also customize this but I won't recommend. So let's create, and after creating this they will give you your app ID and your ad unit ID. So what you can do is just copy these two, your app ID, go to your code, and here in your manifest file, just paste it like this. After that, this is our ad unit ID, which is a real ad, but when we are developing our application, we don't want to display our real ads. This way, our application will be banned and account will be banned also. So to fix this issue, for development purpose, you can go to this banner implement guide. And after opening this, just scroll a bit, and here it is a ad unit ID. So just copy it and go back to your code, close this file, and here you can create another variable, so variable ad unit, and just pass this here. So I'll comment it as testing ad ID, and after that we can simply pass it here like this. So our process is done. So let's run this application on our device and see if ads loads or not. But before that, we have to go to our main.dart file, and here in our main method, we have to initialize two things. One is widget flutter binding dot ensure initialized, and other is to initialize our Google Mobile SDK. So for that, we have to pass Google Mobile ads dot instance dot initialize. This will make sure that our SDK initialized, and then this method will work. And here our application is loaded, but ad is failed to load. Let's see why. So the issue is, we have to set our device as a test device so that we can get our ads. For that, we have to use this thing. So in our this method, let's make it async and wait for that. And after that, we have to create request configuration and name it request configuration is equal to request configuration. And in this, we have to pass the test device IDs. And here, this is our test device ID. So just copy it. And after that, just create another list. For example, var devices, and make it an array, and paste your ad ID here, and test device IDs, paste your devices here. And after that, mobile ads dot instance dot update request configuration, and here you have to pass your request configuration. So our request is added. Now let's restart our application and see. And here you can see our banner ad has been displayed. So we have successfully implemented everything for our banner ad. So if we just cut this thing from here and remove this bottom navigation bar, and in this center thing, and use a column, and in this column just paste it. And now we have to restart our application. Our banner ad is displayed at the top of our screen. So this way you can implement your banner ads easily. We can also customize the size of it. So if we want to change the size, let me just change it. So banner size dot full banner or large banner. So let's try this large banner here. Just restart our application, because every time we change something, we have to restart our application. So here is our large banner. We can change it as we want. So I hope you found this video helpful. If yes, please press that like button and subscribe to the channel for more amazing incoming content. So see you next time. Till that, Allah Hafiz.